So here we are at Finniss in South Australia in a lupin crop looking for snails and whether they'll be a problem at harvest time. As we all know, particularly in pulses, the common white snail, which we have at this site, comes up to the canopy as a response to the conditions drying out because that's where they invest over summer. It doesn't actually feed on green plant material, it only feeds on the dead plant material. So particularly where farmers have been no-tilling and retaining their stubble to improve their soil, they're seeing more and more of a problem with these snails. These snails are not just a South Australian problem either. They've spread over to Western Australia and even up into New South Wales now. Baiting at this time of year can be a problem, particularly because the snails have an alternate food to feed on, but also there's a 60-day withholding period. So if this crop was to be harvested in October, we cannot apply bait now. So there's a lot of limitations about baiting for snails in the springtime. So really, it's about finding out where the problems are now and understanding so we get our bait out next year in March, April, before they start breeding. So how about we go off and do some sampling? So we've got our trusty 30 centimetre by 30 centimetre quadrat. As per the Basham, Bait and Burnham book, pop this down on the ground and then we'll count the number of snails in it. Now you'll notice the snails here are just on the stubble. They're not on the plant material. That's because this species doesn't eat green plant material. It feeds on dry plant matter. The snail movement up into the canopy at harvest time is a response to the drying conditions. You must remember that the snails are very worried about drying out. So at the moment they're down on the ground where it's nice and moist. So again, retaining stubble provides them more food and provides them a better environment. But then understanding that movement is quite important because actually when the snails are really dry, so they're quite pasty, they won't actually be feeding. Whereas if you looked at them now, they'd be quite juicy. So if we crush one, it's very juicy. They're actively feeding at the moment. And so that's really important again for bait timing. And that's why we're using the modern technology and probably moving away from these quadrats using cameras to try and understand more about their behavior. And so getting the bait timing right. So when they are actually actively feeding and they're all juiced up. So although looking in these quadrats is all fun and games and that, it really doesn't tell us much about the activity of these snails. So Michael Richards, with some funding from NRM, come up with these ideas of using these cameras and been using them to actually look at snail activity. And we've actually found that snails don't need rainfall to be active. They actually can be active on 90% relative humidity. And that's quite important because then we put some bait under the cameras. It's really important to understand when the snails are feeding, because of course, if you're trying to kill them with baits, they actually need to be eating on the baits. So again, we're using cameras and we can see the snails roaring around underneath the camera and we can get an idea of their behavior and their activity. So along with that, we're using these hobo microstations here to actually log information from all these sensors down here, and that keeps all the environmental data. And then we come along, hook it up to the laptop and get all the information so we can tie that to the snail activity that we're using the camera to observe.